BambuLab polycarbonate, but does it matter if it is in black or white color or transparent? By the way, nice song. A song from my childhood. Hello, welcome to another BambuLab filament testing video, and this time polycarbonate, and I have this in three colors. The black one I bought myself, and later BambuLab sent me the other two. And interestingly, immediately on the box I can see different recommended print temperatures. I'm not sure because on the black it requires lower temperatures, or this is because it's early product and later they change in the meantime. Anyway, I will use the different settings in the Bambu Studio. About the polycarbonate, there's some main specifications. It is temperature resistant material with excellent mechanical properties, high impact strength and durability. The price is around $40 in US. And as I mentioned, the print temperature varies on the box, but I've used the different settings in Bambu Studio. The bed temperature between 90 and 110 degrees Celsius, but of course depends on the build plate type. I like to use the engineering plate with the glue on it. And it is able to be printed on high speeds, 300 millimeters per second. So again, I will use the different settings in the slicer. It is on a high temperature resistance spool, which can be heated up to 90 degrees Celsius, you know, for the drying. But I will not dry them, I will use them out of the box. Sometimes they use the resealable bags, while this one is not resealable. Even on the spool I can see the recommended print temperature between 260 and 280 degrees Celsius. I'm curious if this is the case with the other two. Yes, but the black we still have that lower print temperature between 250 and 270 degrees Celsius. But these filaments I will take out from the bags before the printing, because as I mentioned, they will be printed out of the box without drying. And I start with the transparent one. These are my test objects in the slicer, and let's see the default settings. 280 degrees Celsius, another 110 on the bed, and 18 is the flow rate. And these are the cooling settings. And I also checked if I change the color, if those settings will be changed, but no, it still has the same print temperature. And I'm starting with the transparent filament. I wasn't here, the bed cooled down a little bit. Bed adhesion check.
Okay. And thanks to the glue, I know that it sticks good.
White color at the full speed.
And this printing was perfect too, without any signs of the warping. And after printing, I can switch to the black color.
Actually, only now I noticed that this is not completely black, but so-called clear black.
And independent from the color, this printing was perfect too. And one more time, side by side, these three printings, and in all three cases, I got complete identical test objects, of course in different color. And objects are ready for the mechanical testings.
Also, I was curious about the transparency. This was printed in a vase mode, and it has three bottom layers. And this is the side wall, flat and also curved.
Just quickly, I want to check the shrinking, which is important for dimensional accuracy. 79.73. 79.6. 79.72. So a little bit more shrinking on the transparent one. And just for reference, regular ABS has a shrinking of 0.5%, and this would be 79.6 millimeters. The tensile test with horizontally printed test objects, and this is the average value for the white. Transparent, little bit weaker, and this is the black one, little bit stronger. The layer adhesion with vertically printed test objects, this is very good value for the polycarbonate, actually for any other material. Transparent slightly stronger. The black one, this is good too, and this means they are good in tensile and in the layer adhesion test. Two-sided shear stress, the diameter is 5 mm, and I will have horizontally and vertically printed test objects. I'm starting with horizontal ones, side by side all three. The difference is minimal, but very strong in this test. I almost forgot how strong is the polycarbonate. This is how it looks like pulling 170 kg, but I have a big gravity force. These are printed in vertical position, so the layer adhesion is important here, and actually strong in all three cases. And now the torque or twist test. With horizontally and vertically printed test objects, I'm starting with the horizontal ones.
And there is a difference in between the numbers, but also in the brake types. And these are printed in vertical position, and they break very suddenly. I never saw so big differences between the colors, and this type of the brake is side of the great layer adhesion. 3-point bending test when I will place these loads one by one, and I'm measuring the deformation after 1, 30 and 60 seconds, currently 1.25 kg, 2.5 kg load, 5 kg load, and 10 kg, and pay attention, almost no additional deformation during the time under these loads. And visually, no permanent deformation on these test objects. The temperature test in the oven, where I want to record the temperature of the first deformation. And this is speed up time-lapse video, and they all started on a form above 100 degrees Celsius, but again I could see some difference between the colors. The black was the best in this case. I stopped the experiment at 160 degrees Celsius, and now let's analyze the objects. And I just removed the load, but even now I can see the difference in the deformation, so the white is the worst and the black is the best.
The creep test, the deformation under the constant load of 1.25 kg. 1584. 1607, interesting, more deformation on the transparent version. 1607, equal deformation on the black. So the initial deformation is equal on the transparent and the black one, and a little bit smaller on the white version.
This became a morning routine to measure them. This is the fifth day and the last measuring. 1624, 1640, 1658. The difference between them is not big, below 0.2 millimeters, but now let's remove the load. And almost immediately after I removed the load, they got back their original shape. I cannot see any permanent deformation on them.
And now guys, the impact test with this half kilogram hammer. White, zero position, transparent, blank.
I'm not sure at this moment, but I thought it's tougher material, but let's analyze the footage.
This is the zero position of the hammer, and this is after breaking the white test objects, after the transparent one, and after the black one. So between these three, the black is toughest, but all three are very brittle materials. And this may be the only reason why we would like to choose the ABS instead of the polycarbonate. And now the results. This Excel table you can download from mytech1.com website, and for my Patreon supporters, I'm adding these three lines to that summary table so they can compare these results to any of those which I did in earlier videos. Let's start with the creep test. On this table or on this graph, you can see the distance between two reference surfaces. But maybe here we can see better the difference between 2 days, the creeping. And this starts from 0.5, so this is extremely minimal creeping. This material resists really good to the creeping stress. Tensile test, a very strong material. Yes, we can see some difference between colors, but in all three cases, this is very strong material. On the layer adhesion test, this is also again very strong here. I left this graph to start from 120, so it is comparable. But anyway, this is very strong for the polycarbonate or for any other material actually. On shear stress, again very strong in this test. It was really hard to break these test objects. And again, we can see some minimal difference between the colors. On the vertically printed objects, where the layer adhesion is important, and here the transparent was slightly stronger compared to the other two. On 3-point bending test, here we can see the deformation under these loads after 30 seconds. But let's take a look on this graph. Here we can see the deformation under these loads after 1, 30 and 60 seconds. And there is some minimal difference between them, but hardly noticeable. But what is more interesting here, that even on a 10 kilograms, this part of the line is nearly horizontal. This means it don't have any additional deformation during this time, even under 10 kilograms. Very stiff material. On the torque or twist test, on horizontal printed objects, this is the load at 90 degree rotation. Again, a big difference between the colors. Here the transparent was much stronger, but not only between the numbers, but between the brake type. You can check the footage. And these test objects are printed in vertical position. And here we can see a little bit smaller difference between these colors. On the ISOT impact test, theoretically, yes, the black is a little bit stronger, tougher material, but in all three cases, this is extremely brittle material compared to the ABS or any other material, actually. So this may be the only reason why we would like to choose the ABS instead of the polycarbonate. On the temperature test, again, we can see some difference between the colors. So the clear black was the best in this test compared to the other two. And yes, I measured the shrinking, some minimal difference between the shrinking. So the transparent had a little bit more shrinking, very similar to ABS compared to the other two.
Interesting. I already have several videos when I tested the same material in different colors. And usually the difference is negligible. But here I could experience a little bit bigger difference in mechanical properties between the colors, in shrinking, in the layer adhesion, in tensile strength, which is almost independent from the print settings. But I use the same gcode here anyway. So yes, we have some difference in mechanical properties between the colors, but anyway, this is very strong material. And if you are able to print from polycarbonate, in that case, I can highly recommend this material over the ABS. What's in the progress? BambuLab nylon filaments, PA6 CF and GF, and after this the PPA CF. It needs some time because after the printing I have to wait until it absorbs some moisture and it will have stable mechanical properties. But you just subscribe and click the notification bell button too. In that case you will not miss that video when it will be finished. Big thanks to my Patreon supporters because they keep this channel alive with these donations. Without them there will be very minimal activity here. And to all you others, thank you for watching and happy printing!